The current BCG vaccine that's being used to prevent TB is not very effective, it's not very efficient, and there's a big issue with drug resistance in TB at the moment. So what we've done is we made a new TB vaccine by including in the vaccine a new adjuvant that stimulates the immune system and it flags up the vaccine to the immune system, so you get a much better cellular and humoral immune response against the TB antigen. We can make a better vaccine, but it needs to be thermally stable so we can transport it to places where the vaccine is needed.
My name is Asel Sadbaeva. I'm a lecturer in chemistry at the University of Bath. A majority of the vaccines have to be kept refrigerated between 2 and 8 degrees. It's incredibly restrictive and very narrow temperature range, obviously. And in most of the countries around the world, when we want to transport them, if there is no electricity or if there is no fridge, it's impossible. But if we don't need refrigeration, if we will just use insulation instead, then we will be able to bring those vaccines to people who need them in the remote countries. So insulation is a new method where we apply an inorganic material, silica, to proteins, and we make sort of a network out of this inorganic material. And this network consists of very strong covalent bonds. So once we make this silica network around the proteins, it sort of keeps them intact and it keeps them from unraveling and spoiling. In this study specifically, we looked at TB, potential TB vaccine, but in general, we are also looking at other vaccines. So we've already looked at tetanus, we're doing diphtheria at the moment, potentially we're interested in doing pertussis, which would obviously cover the whole DTB vaccine, diphtheria, tetanus, pertussis. But also we think that this method will be applicable on many other vaccines in the future.